morning, friends. So, in the previous class, we are discussing a slot in capital budgeting, namely life disparity problems. We were doing portfolio management, where we completed the levered beta, unlevered beta and proxy beta concept, but due to holidays, so many people didn't come previous class, hence I didn't want to start the sharp single index model. So we are doing a small slot called as life disparity problems in capital budgeting. In that we completed two sums, namely replacement cycle problems. One more sum we'll be discussing now called as abandonment, which is also having a small link to the life disparity. We'll complete that sum because I cannot come back and redo that sum once again. Then I have to once again discuss a life disparity fully. So I'll complete that particular problem in another 20 minutes. Then we'll be starting with the next area called a sharp single index model. A very, very important concept. In examination, this is also very regularly asked, like CAPM or risk return profile. Today's class and tomorrow's class will complete the sharp single index model, also start with the arbitrage pricing theory. In one more class, we'll be completing this chapter, portfolio management. Just to once again make a reminder or request, revise the portions regularly then and there, mainly this chapter portfolio, because lot of issues, intricacies are involved. It is not just doing problems or solutions. Okay, every solution will be seeming to be very small only, but the rationale behind each and every solution is big. We have so many notes written. Every word which has been written in the notes should be clearly understood by you. Then only will be said to be having a grip over this chapter, portfolio management. Otherwise, the time invested by me becomes not fruitful. Right or not? Same way, for you also, waking up and coming here for so many classes will become waste unless you revise the chapter immediately. Always don't go for a suboptimal preparation. Try to understand everything which has been spoken in the class. That will give you good clarity regarding any examination problem regarding this chapter. Once I complete the portfolio, I'll do another important area called as leasing in capital budgeting, which is always asked in every examination. Surely one question from leasing is being asked in the exams. We'll be doing that particular area. Naturally, I should be continuing with the mutual funds, an extension of portfolio. Too much of beta, alpha and all, maybe somewhat saturation point we might have reached. Hence, to have a break, we go for leasing and some advanced capital budgeting concepts. Then come back to mutual funds and equity valuation completed before you go for the last leg of the session in the area called as derivatives. Okay, now, life disparity we were discussing. Two projects with unequal lives. One is a project with a 3 years life, another is a project with a 4 years life. Tell me, can I compare the NPV of the two and select based on highest NPV? No. It is improper to compare NPV of a 3 year project with a 4 year project. Naturally, longer the life, more may be the net present value. The right way to do it is into make them into equal life and compare. One option is 3 years project do 4 times, 4 years project do 3 times, make them into 12 years and then compare, or find out NPV per annum, which we call as EAB, equated annuity benefit, which is nothing but NPV divided by annuity factor. NPV is the total benefit from the project. If I divide by the annuity factor, I get the annuity benefit. If the decision involved is about selection of a lowest cost alternative where the cash flows are predominantly outflows, in that case calculate EAC, net discounted outflow divided by annuity factor, select that having the lowest EAC. They did two problems in the final level. One replacement cycle problem, another is replacement cycle with how many years new machine should be kept. In these two problems, we apply the concept of EAB or EAC in making the decisions. Those two sums are difficult to identify for the first time that it is a life disparity problem. But from now onwards, we should be knowing that replacement cycle is all about life disparity decision making. Can I push or not? No. One more sum in that slot I'll discuss now called as abandonment problem, and then go for the portfolio management chapter once again. Okay, now please take. Question number 11, page number 48, please. Question number 11, page number 48. Those who are absent in the previous class, don't look surprised what we are doing. We are just change the track. We are doing one slot in capital budgeting. We'll complete that and then come back to our original discussion portfolio. Okay, take question number 11. Settle down, stop talking, please. One of the examination problem also. Motherland company plans to invest ₹2,50,000 in a project for which the following returns and abandonment values are predicted. Its cost of capital is 18% per annum. Advise the company. Year 1, the project is having 6 years life. Year 1 return 40,000, year 2 return 60,000, year 3 1 lakh, year 4 1 lakh, year 5 1 lakh, and year 6 is 1 lakh. Abandonment value, if I sell the project in first year 2,25,000, second year 1,80,000, slowly as the life increases, abandonment value decreases. Okay, that's the question. Let us discuss what it is all about before you go for the solution. See, normally at IPCC level we consider capital budgeting decision as a static decision, where if there is a project with 6 years life, we have only two choices. Either invest in the project, be inside the project for 6 years and then come out, or don't invest at all. Everybody following on? That is, when I start a project, in all IPCC problems, we assume that we will be doing the project for the full life. Everybody following up? But it may not be so, because a 6 years project, I need not be in the project for 6 years. I may be in the project for 3 years, at the end of the 3rd year, transfer the project to some other person, also come back. Every project is having an abandonment option. Is having what? An abandonment option. Okay. Above that option to abandon, there is a value that can be, you say, found out, which we will be discussing later in advanced capital budgeting techniques, where how to value an abandonment option. In derivatives, we will be using the Black-Scholes model and all to value this abandonment option. But now what I wanted to know is, any project which is there for a given life need not be that we should be in the project for so many years. A 6 years project I can do in for 1 year. If I don't like it, I can sell it and what? Come back. There may exist a market which can buy a project which has already started. Everybody following or not? Now, abandonment value may be transferring the project or selling the assets and what? Coming out. That is what we call as abandonment value. In this case, this project is for how many years? 6 years. First option is, I can do the project for 1 year and then come out of it. In that case, tell me, what are all the inflows? 40,000, 2,25,000. Or I can do the project for 2 years and come out of it. Tell me the cash flow. 40,000, 60,000 and 1,80,000. I do the project for 3 years and come out of it. What is the cash flow? 40,000, 60,000, 1 lakh. And then sell at 1 lakh, 60,000. Like that, I'll be having the cash flows up to the period and then also the abandonment value. Now, the advantage of doing the project for the full life is I can enjoy the full return, spawn, is on home. But the disadvantage is as the project life increases, its abandonment value decreases. It is vice versa. Now the question is, what should be the optimum project doing period? So should I come out after 1, 2, 3, 4 or be there up to how many years? 6 years. So what is the optimum abandonment period is what the question is all about. Shall I proceed or not? Now, let us start doing the calculation. I will do it and then give you time to copy it. You should, or we can just do it together or not. Let's do the calculation together. And you should be doing the calculation. Don't watch like a movie. Okay, it's a very, very simple calculation only. Now, okay, write down step one. Let's do it together. Step one. Abandonment cash flow at present value terms. Abandonment cash flow at present value terms. Abandonment cash flow at present value terms. I have the slide to make the later computation easy. Okay, abandonment value or abandonment cash flow at present value terms. Here, present value factor, abandonment value, discounted cash flow. Here, present value factor, abandonment value, abandonment at present value. Abandonment at present value. Okay, can we do it together or not? Now, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6. What is the interest rate to be used for discounting? 18%. Calculator 1 divided by 1.18. What is the PV factor we will be having? 0.8474. Second year PV factor is 0.7181. Third year is 0.6086. Fourth year PV factor 0.5158. Please do along with me 0.5158. Fifth year present value factor 0.4371. Last year 0.3704. Every year they give me the abandonment value, I written in thousands. The numbers are written in what? Thousands. When I abandon first year, what is the value? 225. 225,000 or 225. Second year if I abandon, I'll be getting 180. Third year, 160. Fourth year, 150. Fifth year, 125. Last, zero. Last is zero. Just whether to know we are awake or not, all these cash flows will come or not? Yes, sir. All this will come or no? It is only just any one only we can receive here. If I abandon in first year, I'll be getting what? 225. Abandon in six, I'll be getting what? Nothing. Don't add all the six here. All the six will not come together. It is only one of it that will be coming to me. Any read or not? Good morning, friends. Energy level, yeah. Can I proceed now? Please. Abandonment value at present value terms na discounted. 0.8474 into 225, 190.67. 0.8474 into 225, 190.67. 180 into 0.7181, 129.26. 180 into 0.7181, 129.26. 160 into 0.6086, 97.38. 150 into 0.5158, 77.37. 125 into 0.4371, 54.64. 54.61. Last is what? 0. Can I add the last column? Why can't I add? All are different options. I cannot add everything. Yes or no? No. Next. This we had only to make the next slide easier. We need not do the working there. Can I put it or not? Now. Step 1 over. Everybody doing along with me here? Now. Step 2, write down. Selecting. I'll give the heading. Step 2, write. Selecting optimal project holding period. Selecting optimal project holding period. Selecting optimal project holding period. Optimal project holding period. Okay. Have the following columns open quickly, please. Year, present value factor, cash flow, discounted cash flow, sigma discounted cash flow, abandonment value at present value, discounted cash inflow, net present value. Don't worry, when you put the numbers, you'll be understanding it. These are all now rocket science. Just I have merged the tables to make it much more smaller, the presentation, that's all. Only presentation angle, we can present anyway in the examination the given answer. Can I proceed? Now. Shall we start doing the solution together or not?
Yes.
Now. Year 1. What the present value factor for year 1? Tell me it is 0.8474. 0.8474. Look at the workbook and tell me the first year the project gives me how much return? 40,000. Cash flow is 40,000. Numbers are written in thousands. Understand that cash flow is 40. 40 into 0.8474 will be giving me how much? 33.90. That gives me 33.90. Cumulative is total. That is also 33.90. 33.90. Suppose I abandon the project in first year itself. In that case, what is the abandonment value in present value terms I'll be getting? 190.67. So, understand that if I do the project for 1 year, the first year discounted cash flow I get is how much? 33.90. I also get an abandoned value, then 190.67. Tell me what is the total discounted inflow the project gives me? 224.57. Inflow is 224.57. This I keep the project for how many years? 1 year. What is the investment made? Look at the problem. 2,50,000. 250. Tell me NPV. 224 minus 250. Minus 25.43. Minus 25.43. Minus 25.43. That's it. Everybody understanding it or not? Now. Suppose I say, I don't want to keep the project for 1 year. I want to keep it for what? 2 years. Then we'll be getting the second year cash flow also or not? Now, write down 2. 2 years. What the present value factor? 0.7181. 0.7181. What the cash flow I get? 60,000. The cash flow I get is 60,000. Discounted cash flow is 60 into 0.7181. 43.09. 43.09. Cumulative is, can I add 40 and 60, say I'll be getting 100? No. Why 40 and 60 cannot be added? Because they have what? Different time value of money. Can I add 33.9 and 43.09? Yes. Because these two are what? The discounted cash flows. So what is the number here? It is 76.99. If I abandon at the end of second year, tell me what is the abandonment value, present value, please tell me. 129.26. This number you should only tell me from the notebook which I copied in the previous slide. So 129.26. 76.99 plus 129.26 gives me a discounted inflow of 206.25. Gives me a discounted inflow of 206.25. 206.25. Now, tell me, what is the investment? 250. 206.25 minus 250, what is the net present value? Minus 43.75. Okay. Now, please stop writing. I'll once again tell what I am doing here before I start filling the remaining numbers. Please, everybody listen. Now, I have completed two options. First option is what? Abandoned at the end of the first year. My NPV is what? Minus 25.43. Second option is what? Abandoned at the end of the second year. My NPV is what? Minus 43.75. I'll tell you what I did here. Very simple. If I abandon at the end of first year, I'll be getting a cash flow of 40. First year cash flow. And an abandonment value of 2,25,000. The present value of that 40 is 33.9 and the present value of 2,25,000 is what? 190.07. The total discounted inflow is 224.57. From that I reduce what? Outflow to find out the NPV. Respond, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Suppose I keep the project for how many years here? 2 years. Tell me what I will get? 40 and 60. Now, the present value of 40 and 60, I call as what? Cumulative discounted cash flow. Because the discounted cash flow for 40 is 33.9 and then 60 is what? 43.09. I get the both the cash flows or not? Yes. I just add these two. I get 76.99 as the operating inflow. Yes or no? Plus what is the abandonment value? 129.26. It is something with present value of 1,80,000. Am I right or not? Then I'll be getting a discounted inflow of 206 minus 250 gives you the NPV. Enough right or not? Now. Answer and then proceed. If I keep the project for 3 years, tell me what I will get. Everybody, tell me, I want to hear all voices. If I 40, 60, 1 lakh and then 1,60,000. Right or not? Now, third year. If I keep it for 3 years, PV factor is 0.6086. 3 years, 0.6086. What is the third year inflow I will be getting? 1 lakh, 100. It is 60.86. I'll get only 60.86. I'll get 33.9, 43.09 and 60.86. All the three. I'm keeping the project for 3 years and I'll be earning what? All the three returns. The total of all the three is nothing but 137.85. The total of all the three is 137.85. I can sell at the end of year 3 at 1,60,000 whose present value is 97.38. The present value is 97.38. I want everybody to participate. Tell me what is the discounted cash inflow? 235.23. Discounted cash inflow is 235.23. What is the net present value? Minus 14.77. NPV is minus 14.77. Minus 14.77. Can I proceed? Next. Point number 4. That is, sorry, year number 4. Year 4. What are the cash flow I am getting? 1 lakh. PV factor is 0.5158, PV is 0.5158, cash flow is 1 lakh, discounted cash flow 51.58, cumulative discounted cash flow is 189.43, I'm awake, I did not see properly, okay, 189.43. Now, what is the abandonment value in present value term? 77.37. 189.43 plus 77.37 gives you what number? 266.80. Minus what? 250. What the NPV? 16.80. NPV 16.80. Positive 16.80. Next. If I keep the project for 5 years. I keep it for 5 years. PV factor is 0.4371. Cash flow is how much M? 1 lakh or 100. The discounted cash flow 43.71. The cumulative discounted cash flow is 233.14. Sigma discounted cash flow 233.14. Abandoned value in present value term 54.64. What is the discounted cash inflow? 287.78. What is the NPV? 37.78. year 6, if I keep it for 6th year present value factor 0.3704. 6th value factor 0.3704. I hope you are following not. Now what is the cash flow having? 1 lakh. Cash flow is 1 lakh. What is the discounted cash flow? 37.04. What is the sigma discounted cash flow? 270.18. Abandonment is nil. Abandonment is nil. What is discounted cash inflow? 270.18. What is NPV? 20.18. NPV is 20.18. Respond everybody. Are you following or not? Now. Can I proceed? Now. Tell me. Which is having the highest NPV? Option number 5. That means I have to keep the project for how many years? 5 years. And then abandon. Right or not? Yes or no? You see, good morning friends. We are continuing last class or not? Now, I ask you a question. Minus 25.13 is the NPV of how many years project? 1 year project. Minus 43.75 NPV, how many years project? 2 years project. Right or not? This 20.18 is the NPV of a 6 year project. Everybody respond, yes or no? Now. All this NPV are coming out of an equal life projects or unequal life option, unequal life options. You know, yes or no? Now, one option is for 1 year, another option gives you a cash flow for 2 years and so on. There is a life disparity here, right or not? Yes or no? Now, should I decide based on NPV or EAB?
EAB.
What is EAB? NPV divided by annuity factor. So we should decide based on EAB because the problem is what? Life disparity. Yes or no? But we should not be using EAB here. We should not be using what? EAB here. Wherever life disparity comes, we should not say, we should be using what? EAB. EAB can be used only when there is an intention to repeat. Punjaba. When an intention to what? Repeat. Now, let us go back to the example which we discussed in the previous class. I had a machine one. I had machine one. Yamar gaba? I had two projects A and B. Year 0, I invest how much? 50 in both. 1, 2, it is what? 30, 90. This is what? 90 dash. Respond, yes or no? This was an example we had, right? Now, NPV of A will be higher than what? NPV of B, which also we saw earlier. It is a simple calculation, right? Yes or no? Now, I said select A because A is having what? High NPV. We said it is correct or wrong? I'm wrong. Because this is a 2 years project NPV. That is what? 1 year project NPV. We said that it should not be compared. The reason is by the time I complete A, I can do B how many times here? 2 times. So I said B can be done minus 50. Then what? 90 minus 50 is equal to 40. And then 90. This was the last class discussion, right or not? I said which is good, 50, 30, 90, 50, 40, 90. B was selected. Instead of repetition method, we can even calculate paranum and compare. Is what is our discussion in the previous class, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, see, B is better than A only if B can be repeated. Right?
Yes,
suppose B cannot be repeated. B cannot be what? Repeated. Then I'll rather go for what? A than going for what? B. I can work one more year, earn a more NPV rather than what? Completing yearly, sitting idle for 1 year. Right or not?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand my question or not? Now, B will become more, that is better than A only when B can be repeated 2 times by the time A gets what? Completed. If the B cannot be repeated, then it is better to go for what? Higher NPV project because that is going to give me more NPV. It is better to work 2 years and earn more NPV than what? Work only 1 year and less NPV. Respond, yes or no? One simple say, example I give, examination, a person writes 3 hours. A person writes what? 3 hours and scores 70 marks. Score how many marks there? 70 marks. Another person writes 2 hours and scores what? 69 marks. Tell me who is better? Tell me who is better? Because That 1 hour what he spent, don't say getting only 1 mark. He got that 1 mark. Yeah, he did not get it, right or not? You would understand my question or not? See, a person is writing for 3 hours scoring 70 marks. Another person is writing what? 2 hours. I'm scoring what? 69 marks. When it will be better now? If the questions can be what? Repeated. I'll be getting marks or repetition. Are you following what I'm saying? In that case, I say 2 hours 69, then 4 hours becomes what? 128, 138 and so on. They can just say what? His rate of scoring is what? Very high. He is scoring faster than the other person. Then he will be selected. Is or no? Bad. 3 hours, you can write only once here. Okay. A person writing 2, he said in 2 hours I got 69 marks. He got only 70 in what? 3 hours. Now still the 70 is what? Better, because he worked for 1 more hour and then he earned what? 1 mark. How much it is not important, that the extra is not. Am I right or not? Now. So, in case of repetition, B is better, because by the time A is over. That is, suppose the examiner says that 2 hours if you complete FR, you can start writing what? SFM examination, I'll give you 1 hour extra. Now, in that case, I'll say first person is what? Good, because for the 1 mark unnecessary not spend what? 1 more hour, you can start writing what? SFM examination. That exam anyhow question will not be understood, but still you can try hard to what? Read the question, understand and write it. In that case, the first person completing 69 marks in 2 hours is what? Good. But 3 hours anyhow you have to take. Okay, in that case, I'll rather go for that 1 mark with 1 hour than go for what? A lower number of hours with the higher marks. Everybody, are you following or not? Now, same thing happens here also. When there is a repetition only, what I can say is life disparity, EAB or repetition method should be applied. When there is no repetition, even though life disparity may exist, it is better to go for what? NPV. Yeah, 7 years project giving an NPV of some 10 crores and 6 years project giving an NPV of something around 9 crores. Now, still I go for what? 7 years project with NPV of 10 crores. If the 6 year project cannot be repeated once again, everybody, yes or no? So now tell me, EAB, EAC concept can be used when there is a life disparity and there should be a scope for what? Repetition. We saw replacement cycle problem. We see all the sums which I have discussed in replacement, 2 sums. They said the machine is going to be used continuously. It's going to be used what? Continuously. Suppose the machine is having 3 years life. If I keep it for 1 year, I'll be surely replacing once again at what? Second year and using it forever. Are you following what I'm saying? So only the same project can be repeated or the same machine can be what? Used continuously. I can use the concept of EAB or EAC. Number eight or not? No. In this problem, it is abandonment. It is what? Abandonment. That is, I start a project, I abandon. There is no guarantee that the same project should be obtained what? Once again. The word abandonment indicates that I am not going to repeat it. If I am going to repeat it, why should I invest once again? Yeah, already one investment is that it is going to give me for 6 years cash flow. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? So the abandonment always indicates what? An intention not to repeat. So even it's a life disparity and the problem is all about abandonment, can I apply EAB, EAC or I should not apply? I should not apply, because in IPCC always life disparity means EAB, EAC we apply it or not, but it may not be always so. In this case, we should not be applying the life disparity. Everybody, I think you are all comfortable or not? Yes, now, to conclude, the ultimate conclusion, we understand or not, but there is a conclusion. Conclusion is, number one, when there is a life disparity, one option is having 3 years, another option is having what? 4 years. When there is a life disparity, we may think about using what? EAB or EAC. But that will be used only when the option has got a chance to get repeated. If the option does not have a chance to get repeated, it's better to go for NPV rather than going for EAB or EAC. In the ultimate conclusion, respond yes or no? Okay, now. So tell me, what is the answer here? The answer is, have to go for what? 50 year. Okay, right on. Conclusion. I think I finished copying the full slide or not? No. Conclusion. Recommended to do the project for 5 years and abandon. Recommended to do the project for 5 years and abandon. Recommended to do the project for 5 years and abandon. Since for this option, NPV is highest. Since for this option, NPV is highest. Everybody understand it or not? Write down notes. Point number one. Each option has different life. Each option has different life. That is, doing a project, strike off keeping, right? Doing a project for two years and abandoning it. Is an option with two years life, having an NPV of -43.75. And I'm just giving you the example to understand it, okay? And doing a project for 4 years. And doing the project for four years and then abandoning. Is an option with 4 years life and then abandoning. Whose NPV is 16.80. Continue. There exists what? Life disparity. Shouldn't we use EAB? Because we saw the life disparity, EAB should be used now. Shouldn't we use EAB? Respond. Yes or no? Question mark. Point number one or two? Two. Point number two is answer. Tell me the answer. Yes or no? No. Point number two, right? Answer as no. Because using EAB inherently assumes that the option has repetition feature. Inherently assumes that the option has repetition feature. Respond yes or no. If it is not there, then use only NPV. Point number two or three? Three. In this problem, when we abandon the project, say at the end of second year, We do not intend to repeat it. Hence, EAB not used. We do not intend to repeat it. Hence, EAB not used. Hence, EAB not used. I hope everybody having the clarity regarding the discussion or not? No. We just discuss one slot in capital budgeting called as what? Life disparity. Investigated three problems, two replacement cycle, good problems, and one problem regarding this abandonment option. Okay, now we'll seriously discuss about capital budgeting later. We were doing mainly the chapter portfolio management. Again, I say for everybody, why we came to capital budget due to me or is due to you only, because you are absent in the last class. I did not want to do a sharp single index, hence I discuss the life disparity. I want to know. Now the class is full. Okay, tell me, those who are absent last class, raise your hand. Why, tell me? Holiday, festival, huh? I gave Tuesday a holiday, right or not? Monday the Tuesday. Thursday you should have returned back, right? No. Now, till the batch end, don't go for any festival. Don't go for what? Any festival. I also will not go for festivals. You understand? No, please. Stop time. Please. Why I did not do in the previous classes, had I started sharp single index model, today all of you are present now. As if I am doing some criminal act, will be staring at me, something unknown done. So many backgrounds should have been discussed. Hence, I wanted to play it safe. At least you came today happy. Can I present or not? Now.